Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Hope all are doing good. Like, share, subscribe and click on the bell icon for the latest notification of the upcoming videos. Do watch and comment for the videos. So we are done with simple interest, 4 sessions, and in this session we'll cover compound interest topic. So before getting into the topic, I just want you to tell you something that certain people have an idea that compound interest questions are tough and they'll leave it in competitive exam. Actually, it is not. It is quite similar to other topics, but the only thing is the calculation part. It depends on questions you get. At sometimes it may take too long time for you to crack those questions, that too in calculation part. So only that is the problem. Otherwise, it is quite similar to other topics. So if you practice more questions, definitely you can crack these questions very easily, okay? And I'll also give you the shortcut, okay? In this session, we'll cover the basics of compound interest, okay? And those who missed the simple interest topic, I'll give you the link in the description box. You just click on it and view it, okay? We'll start with basics of compound interest. So before giving the definition of compound interest, I'll just give you an example comparing simple interest and compound interest, so you'll have a clear-cut idea on what compound interest is, okay? So let us take an example. Let principal be 1000 rupees, number of years is equal to 1 year, and rate of interest is equal to 10%. So find simple interest. How we will calculate the simple interest? 10% of 1000. Since it is only 1 year, 10% of 1000 you can calculate, or else you can go with the formula PNR by 100. So when you calculate, you get the simple interest as 100 rupees, okay, first year. Even for second year, it is 100 rupees. Third year also, it is 100 rupees. The simple interest remains the same for every year, but while calculating, for second year also, when you calculate 10% of 1000, second year you get 100 rupees, third year you get 100 rupees. So when you add all these simple interest plus the principal, you will get the amount, right? Yes. But for compound interest, it is not so. For first year, it remains the same as the simple interest, 100 rupees, okay? But for second year, it increases, okay? That is because in first year, we'll calculate the rate of interest only for principal. But for compound interest, for second year onwards, we will calculate the rate of interest for both principal as well as the compound interest that we got in first year. Similarly, for third year, how we'll do? We'll calculate the rate of interest for principal, rate of interest for first year in compound interest, and rate of interest for second year compound interest, okay? So every year it increases, compound interest increases. That is why its name is compound interest, okay? This is what the basic is. Then if you see the formula, in SI, you'll have a direct formula that will calculate you simple interest. But for CI, you'll have the formula for amount, okay? Amount is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 the whole power N. This is the formula, okay? So, substituting this value, you get it as amount is equal to 1100. We know principal plus compound interest is your amount. So since you have to get compound interest, you will subtract principal from amount. So 1100 minus 1000, you will get the compound interest as 100 rupees for first year. For second year, how you will calculate? 10%, that is the rate of interest, right? So 10% of your principal plus 10% of your first year compound interest. So on total, you get it as 110, okay? Similarly, for third year, 10% of principal plus 10% of first year compound interest plus 10% of second year compound interest. Okay, you get it as 121. Likewise, it goes on. So, you know principal plus compound interest is equal to amount, or principal plus simple interest is equal to amount. Okay, here for compound interest, principal plus compound interest is equal to amount. Since we know 10% of P plus 10% of first compound interest gives your value, you can directly find 10% of your amount, right? Yes, that is what I have given in the left hand side, so you can check with it. Okay, so this is how you will have to find the compound interest. In this session, I'll just give you some methods to find compound interest. Okay, like you can go with formula or the method you know, but I'll give you some extra methods. The four easiest method I have chosen so that you can apply that to problems wherever it is needed. Okay, okay, let us see. Let us see the important terms that are used in compound interest. P is principal, R is rate of interest, N is number of years, CI is compound interest, and A is amount. And I have given you the formula: A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 the whole power N, and CI is equal to A minus P. I hope you know this, okay? We have three different terms that is not used in SI but in CA. What are those three terms? We will see. Compounded annually, compounded half yearly, compounded quarterly. Okay. Annually means, annual means 1 year, we know. So which means 12 months. So in that case, you don't have to do anything. Just substitute the values that is given in your question. Compounded half yearly means, half yearly means in an year you have 2 half years, right? That is 2 6 months. 6 into 2 is 12 months, which becomes 1 year. So 2 half months. In that case, what you'll have to do, I'll tell you. See, rate of interest is always calculated per annum, I told you earlier. So here, since our question is compounded half yearly, what you'll do, half the year you'll have to find. So R percentage divided by 2 will give you a half yearly rate of interest. Okay, hope you understood. At the same time, since it is 2 half years, you'll have to multiply N into 2. Okay, it is not actually 2 years but 2 half years. Okay, so just N into 2 only. Okay. And compounded quarterly means R percentage by 4 and N into 4. I hope you understood how you got this. We know it is 4 3 months, okay? So R percentage, quarter means 1 by 4, okay? So R percentage by 4 and at the same time N into 4. I hope you understood, okay? Tell you some important points to remember. In simple interest, the interest amount, right, that will remain the same for every year, whereas for compound interest it differs for every year because it is compounded. That is, interest for interest is found. Okay, that is what compound interest is. Okay, then the similarity is, for first year your interest amount for both SI and CI will be the same. Okay, CI is called the interest for interest. So these are the points to remember. Let us start with the first method, which is formula method. I have chosen the easiest value. So for you to understand, you can apply this method to any other numbers. Okay. So P is equal to 100, N is equal to 2, R is equal to 10%. Always remember, for compound interest, your formula is based on amount and not compound interest directly. Okay. So amount is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 the whole power N. Just substitute the value. So 100 into 1 plus 10 by 100 the whole square. So 100 into, taking LCM, 100 plus 10 you will get. So 110 by 100, since it is whole square, again one more 110 by 100. So I am cancelling, you get your amount is equal to 121 rupees. So we will have to calculate compound interest, which is amount minus principal. So 121 minus 100, you will get it as 21 rupees. So you got your compound interest. So similarly, if you have N is equal to 3 years, what you will do? The same procedure, and the only difference is you will have cube, right? So you will have one more 110 by 100. So on substituting, you get your amount as 133.1. So on calculating CI, it is A minus P, which is 133.1 minus 100, you get it as 33.1. So this is how you will have to solve using formula method. Okay, hope you understood. Next, we will see fraction method with the same set of values. Okay, so fraction method means you will convert the percentage into fraction. Here R is the percentage, right? So 10% convert it into fraction, you get it as 1 by 10. Suppose if you don't know how to convert it into fraction, just what number is given in percentage, just write that divided by 100. Here, since it is 10, 10 by 100, on simplification you get it as 1 by 10. Okay, what this 1 by 10 represents? 10 represents principal and 1 represents compound interest. Okay, So as I told you, this is principal amount method. You want principal and amount, okay? So since only CI we know and principal we know, we'll calculate amount. How will you know amount? Principal plus compound interest. So 10 plus 1, which is 11. So when your principal is 10, your amount would be 11. I have written it 2 times just because the number of years is 2. Okay. Suppose if it is 3, you'll have 3 tens and 3 elevens. Okay. Now, after writing that, what you have to do is multiply both the tens and multiply both the elevens. So 10 into 10 is 100, 11 into 11 is 121, right? So when your principal is 100 rupees, your amount would be 121. So our principal is 100 only. So obviously your amount would be 121. So if the question is find the amount, your answer is 121. If the question is find the compound interest, just subtract amount and principal, you get it as 21. So 21 rupees is your compound interest, okay? The same question, we'll find it for 3 years, okay? See, 1 by 10 is their fraction. So, 10 represents principal and CI is 1. Amount would be 10 plus 1, which is 11. So, I have repeatedly written 3 times because it is for 3 years. 10, 11, 10, 11, 10, 11. Now, multiply all the 3 tens and all the 3 elevens. So, 10 cube is 1000 and 11 cube is 1331, okay? So, 1000, when your principal is 1000, your amount is 1331. Our question is principal is 100. So for 100, how much amount you will have to find, okay? So in this question, we'll find the compound interest. So how we will find the compound interest? Amount minus principal. So 1331 minus 1000, you will get it as 331. So that is your compound interest. So for 100 principal, how much compound interest would be there? You will have to find. Since we have a direct relation, see, 1000 divided by 10 is 100. So 331 divided by 10. So you get it as 33.1 as your compound interest. Okay. So I hope you understood. Practice more questions. Definitely you will find this very easy. Since I explain you, it may feel like I'm taking it too long, but actually when you practice, it is quite easy. Okay, see the next method, which is 21331 method. We'll see how to do it. Same value. Okay, so in this case, what you'll have to do, first take what the principal is and write it down in a box. Okay, so 100 is your principal and write it down in a box. So find 10% of 100. So 10% of 100 is nothing but 10. Okay, then find 10% of that 10. 10% of 10 is nothing but 1, right? Now, first step, you need not multiply anything. That is your main principal. You need not touch it, okay? The second step, you will have to multiply it by 2. And the third step, you will have to multiply it by 1 since it is for 2 years. This is because the method is 2-1 method, right? So multiply it by 2 and multiply it by 1. So 10 2s are 20, 1 months are 1. So on adding, you get it as 21. So directly you got the compound interest, right? Now we will see for 3 years, okay? The same value. So 100, put it in box. 10% of 100 is 10. 10% of 10 is 1. And 10% of 1 is 0.1. Okay. Since it is 331 method, from second step you start. Into 3, into 3, into 1. So 10 3s are 30. 1 3s are 3. And 0.1 into 1 is 0.1. So on adding, you get 30 plus 3 plus 0.1, which is 33.1. I hope you understood. Method, this is quite familiar to you, I hope. Those who have watched my videos, obviously you'll know this method, okay? So successive percentage, where you have a formula plus or minus x plus or minus y plus or minus x y by 100. Since compound interest, you will always have an increasing value, you will always have positive values only. So x is 10, y is 10. Since it is for 2 years, x, y by 100. So 10 into 10 by 100. So 20 plus 10 into 10 is 100 by 100, which is 1. So 20 plus 1, which is 21%. So rate of interest is equal to 21% for 2 years we have found. So how to calculate CI? 21% of 100 if you find, you will get the compound interest. So 21% of 100 is nothing but 21. Okay. Now we will see for 3 years. So x plus y plus xy by 100. The same formula, find the first value. You will get it as 21, right? Then use that 21 as x and 10 as y. So 21 plus 10 plus 21 into 10 by 100. So you get the value as 31 plus 2.1. Yes. So on total, you get it as 33.1. So that is your total rate of interest for 3 years. So for the principal of 100, your interest would be. So 33.1 percentage of 100, if you find, you will get the compound interest. So 33.1 percentage of 100 is nothing but 33.1. So that is your answer. So I hope you understood all the 4 methods. Please do practice more questions using this method, because upcoming videos I'll use these methods and explain you. So only then you will get to know about it. And also these methods are definitely very useful at times, like when you get values based on decimals at that time, you can use that fraction method. All really it will be helpful. So practice these questions, and thank you for watching this video. Thank you for all the support given. Keep supporting, and do share the videos, and thank you so much. Thank you.